Yeah, I'm curious what the NBA Players Association says about this with certifying agents. You know, just because college says that you have to be this, just because you have a college degree, like that, and you have to go to Indianapolis to take a test with the NCAA. They're so concerned about these basketball players. Are they concerned about other sports as well? I don't think so. Just a guess there. Oh, boy. When's the last time the NCAA did something where we went, you know, that's the right thing to do? But they did the right thing. This, they came up with the term student athlete back in the mid-70s. I think it was Walter Byers who was the head of the NCAA. It was brilliant. Student athlete. Really, they're athletic students is the way I view it. You can make money if you can go on a band scholarship, right? You can be part of the marching band. And if you want to put out a CD and make money, you can. NCAA doesn't care about that. But if these kids somehow want to better themselves or their families, let's put more restrictions on them. And if you do get drafted and want to come back, I think having that option, it feels like we've become more restrictive instead of less and opening this up to say, let's sort of adapt to modern times here with these kids, with their families, you know, the role of agents. How about it's more transparent? Part of the problem was back in the 70s or 60s, it wasn't transparent. You know, there was stuff that was going on. And then everybody sounded surprised, like, wait, these guys are getting paid? Yeah, I've been getting paid a long time. If you make it transparent, you know, maybe you can start to solve some of these issues here. But the one and done, I thought that college basketball and the NBA could have gotten together and maybe got out in front of this a long time ago. And maybe you do two years. If you go to college, then the NBA can not draft you, or you can't go to the NBA in 2 years. Like, you make a commitment. College baseball, don't you make a commitment when you go to college baseball? Is it 3 years, or at least it used to be? The college football, you have to commit 3 years of your eligibility to college football, and then you go into the NFL. If you say to these kids, you're coming to college, these are our rules when you come to college. We want you to go to college. We want you to be a student. They've left out the student athlete, student part of the athlete. They're the ones that came up with this. If you want them to be student athletes, then invite them in and give them something that says, this is something you can use. This is something you need. Getting 2 years. 2 years is so much different than 1 year, because that 1 year becomes a half year. But if you have to commit, stay eligible, who knows? You may accidentally get a degree. But I don't think college has kind of presented itself in a way that says, boy, this is inviting. If you get drafted coming out of high school and you say, I need to go, I want to play basketball, but if I go to college, I'm going for 2 years. We don't want you to make a mockery of the institution of college education, higher learning. And we've allowed that. And that's the shame. That's the sad part of all of this. You're the ones that called them student athletes. And you're the ones forgetting that they should be students first. They're athletic students.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV. Stream for free on BR Live or download the Dan Patrick Show app.